Hi students, in the earlier class we discussed about the equations of motion and derived v is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at squared, v square minus u square is equal to 2as. Now we will derive the expression sn is equal to u plus a into n minus half. Here Sn is distance or displacement in nth second. This is nth second. So here we will find Sn expression for nth second. Let us consider here this is origin. Now here the body started from origin, let us take now 1 second, 2 second, 3rd second, 4. So likewise here if this is some n minus 1 and this is some nth second. Now what is that nth second? From 1 second to 2 seconds, this interval is second second. This is second second, means 1 second completed and next until 2 seconds completed, the time interval between 1 second and second second is second second. This is third second. From 2 seconds completed and until 3 seconds completed, the gap between second and third seconds are third second. Likewise, here n minus 1 seconds are completed, here n seconds are completed. That means this interval is called nth second. And here this is the distance traveled in nth second. Now, how to find out the distance traveled in nth second? Let us take during n minus 1 seconds, the distance traveled is, this is sum s up to n minus 1 seconds. Distance traveled we are taking as s, and up to n seconds the distance we are taking as s dash. So s is the total distance traveled during n minus 1 seconds. So this is n minus 1 seconds interval. During n seconds interval, distance traveled is s dash. So here the distances are taken from starting point. From 0 seconds to n minus 1 seconds, total time interval is n minus 1. This is time interval during 0 to n minus 1 seconds. During 0 to n seconds, interval is n seconds. Now nth second is from n minus 1 seconds to n seconds, the gap is nth second. So now the total distance traveled during n minus 1 seconds, according to the expression s is equal to ut plus half at squared, let the body starts with an initial velocity u and traversed with an acceleration a. Now during n minus 1 seconds, distance traveled is s is equal to u into n minus 1 plus half a into n minus 1 whole squared. Now during n seconds interval t to n, that is s dash u into n plus half a n squared. So these are the displacements traversed in n minus 1 seconds, n seconds. Now what you have to find out is displacement during nth second. That means s dash minus s gives Sn. S dash minus S gives Sn. So here Sn, S dash, which is un plus half an squared minus S u into n minus 1 minus half a into n minus 1 whole squared. So here this is un plus half an square minus un minus of minus plus u minus half a, this is n square plus 1 minus 2n, a squared plus b squared minus 2ab. Now this becomes here un get cancels. Now the expression becomes half a n squared plus u minus half a n squared minus half a minus of minus plus 2 get cancels, minus of minus plus a n. Now it will be half a n squared gets cancelled. Now S n is equal to u plus a n minus a by 2. Now taking a common here, n minus half, this is S n. So it can also be written as u plus a by 2, taking 2 LCM, 2 n minus 1. So here you have to remember that the difference between S and Sn, S is the distance traveled during a time interval t seconds. So it is the time interval. If the body traveled from 1 second to 4 seconds, interval is 3 seconds interval, that is t. This is the displacement in a particular second, that is nth second. So if you take third second, means distance traveled from 2 seconds to 3 seconds, this is the third second distance. Likewise, distance traveled in nth second, means displacement traveled in n seconds to displacement traveled in n minus 1 seconds, that difference gives displacement traversed in nth second. So remember, this is the expression for Sn. So these are the equations of motion. When we use these equations of motion, these equations of motion are applicable and they are valid when acceleration is constant. Acceleration is constant, then only these equations are applicable. If acceleration changes, definitely the expressions will be modified and we use integration methods. What they are, I will explain you later. Before that, here, if body starts with zero velocity, that means if initial velocity will be zero, then here these expressions become v is equal to at when u is equal to 0, s is equal to half at squared, v square is equal to 2as, sn is equal to a into n minus half. This is when initial velocity is 0. Now here, now you are asked to find the ratio of displacements during time intervals 1 seconds, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, like that. If a body started from rest and you are asked to find out ratio of displacements, so 1 second, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, like that. Then here S is equal to half AT squared, S proportional to T square. Why? Because acceleration is constant to numerical constant. So S changes with the time only. So that S proportional to T squared. Now S1, S2, S2 and so on, you will get T1 squared is to T2 squared is to T3 squared and so on. Now this will be 1 is to 2 squared, 4 is to 3 squared, 9 and so on. So these are the ratio of displacements when time intervals are 1 second, means the displacement traveled in 1 second. Then the displacement traveled in total 2 seconds interval. The displacement traveled in total 3 seconds interval. The ratio of displacements traveled in 1 second, 2 seconds interval, 3 seconds interval, like that. This is the ratio. Similarly, if you are asked to find out initial velocity is 0 and here first second, second second, third second, like that. So these are n's. You are asked to find out distance traveled in first second, second second, third second. Now when the displacement traveled in nth second is given as Sn is equal to A into n minus 1 by 2. Now here first second means here Sn proportional to 2n minus 1. Why? Because this can also be written as A by 2 into 2n minus 1. Now Sn proportional to 2n minus 1. Now for first second, second second, third second, like that. S1 is to S2, S3 and so on will be given as, for S1, for first second, 2 into 1 minus 1, 2 minus 1, 1. For second second, 2 2's 4 minus 1, 3. For third second, 2 3's 6 minus 1, 5. So like that, here the ratio of displacements traveled in first second, second second, third second, like that. So here if we take the motion line, then we can say if this is 0 seconds, then this is 1 second, this is first second, this is 2 seconds, this is second second, this is 3 seconds, this is third second. What we find is, here in this method we find the ratios from the beginning, from the 0 seconds up to 3 seconds, this is S3, this is S2, this is S1. So from 0 to 1 seconds, 1 second time, 0 to 2 seconds, 2 seconds interval, 0 to 3 seconds, 3 seconds interval, like that. In the second method, what we find is, this is S1, this is second method, and this is first method. Now this is first second, so the distance traveled in first second, this is second second, displacement in second second, displacement in third second, like that. So this is the second method and this is the first method. Okay. Now students, S is equal to ut plus half at squared. This can also be derived using graphical method. So The easiness in physics is that if graphs are given in your 2 years curriculum anywhere in physics, if graphs are given, just look at the graph and determine whether you have to find ratio or product. Means here ratio means it is a slope. Always in graphs, whatever be the graph may be, simple technique is if it is a ratio, that means you are finding out slope. That means the physical quantity which you are going to found, that is in terms of ratio, like velocity, displacement by time, acceleration, change in velocity by time. So acceleration is change in velocity by time, that is ratio. So acceleration will be found from velocity time graph as a slope, because ratio is given by slope. And here product, it will be given by area of the graph. This is slope of the graph and this is area of the graph. So here just we assume any graph. This is a velocity time graph. Let us take. Now from this graph, if velocity time graph is a straight line, so for any straight line, slope is constant. For any straight line, slope is constant. Here, what we assumed is on y-axis we are letting velocity, on x-axis we are taking time. At t is equal to 0 seconds, velocity has some initial value which we can say it as u, initial value u, and this is final value, we can write it as v. Now from this graph I will tell you what is the difference between the ratio and product, the slope, the area. Look at here. If you take this graph and if you find slope for this entire graph, so let this time interval be t. Here this is 0 seconds and this is t seconds. Interval is t. Now find the slope. So the slope will be given by, this is the graph. Let this point as A, this point as B, this point as C and this point as D. So here for this graph AB, velocity time graph, we are finding out slope. Slope means y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. Here y2 is v, y1 is u. V minus u, change in velocity by x2 minus x1. On x axis time is t, x2, x1 is 0, that means t minus 0. So this is v minus u by t. This is slope, v minus u, change in velocity divided by time. So this is a ratio. Ratio of change in velocity by time. Change in velocity by time is acceleration. That means here acceleration can be determined from velocity time graph by the help of slope. That means ratio. So slope is a ratio. From velocity time graph, that ratio or slope gives acceleration. The same slope, this is v minus u. Look at here, this is v, this is u. So this is v on y axis, this is u on y axis. Then this will be v minus u, and this is ac, t minus 0, that is a t. So the slope is y2 minus y1. So for this graph, this is opposite side. For this right angle triangle, this is opposite side, this is adjacent side. So here we can assume an angle theta. So tan theta is y2 minus y1, that means v minus u, by x2 minus x1, opposite side by adjacent side, that is tan theta. Here opposite side by adjacent side, which gives slope, that means slope is tan theta. In graphs slope is tan theta. And here in VT graph particularly, that tan theta is given by acceleration, so that is slope. That acceleration is ratio, change in velocity by time. So for any graph, whatever be the graph, if you are finding slope, means for any graph, if you are finding slope, means you have to find y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1, that means opposite side by adjacent side, that is tan theta. That means slope for any graph will be given by tan theta. For this velocity time graph, it is acceleration. So this is about slope. Now about product or area. So look at here. Here you are having a rectangle OACD. You have a rectangle OACD. Here this OA is U. This is U. And OD is T. Now for this OACD area. So for OACD area, area is length into breadth. Here this is T into U. Then area of OACD. Area of OACD, that is area of OACD is from the graph OA into OD. This is the area. So OA into AD means here area is the product into. Now this is OAU into T, UT. Now here this is UT, velocity into time. Velocity into time is displacement. That means the area of OACD gives displacement. What is the graph you have been considered here? Velocity time graph. In velocity time graph, area gives displacement. In the same velocity time graph, slope gives acceleration. So here acceleration is the ratio and displacement is product. Displacement is product. So for the same graph, ratio gives one physical quantity, product gives another physical quantity. Ratio is determined from slope, product is determined from area. So now here for velocity time graph, area of the graph is displacement. Now for this AB graph, area means area under the graph, means here this is the vertical lines I am drawing. It represents the area of triangle, right angled triangle, and the horizontal lines represents area of rectangle. So under the graph AB, area is OABCD. This entire area is under the graph. This entire area of velocity time graph gives displacement. So here area of VT graph is equal to displacement. Then area of VT graph is displacement. Here how many areas are here under the graph? Two areas. One is a triangle, another one is rectangle. So displacement is S is equal to area of triangle ABC plus area of rectangle OACD. So this entire area gives displacement. Now what we discussed here, area is product. Means in any graph, if you are taking product, that is area, it gives one physical quantity. If you take slope, that is ratio, it gives another physical quantity. So only two possibilities from your graphs. If any physical quantity is asked, then you can go for either ratio or product, either slope or area. From this we have integration methods also, so it will be discussed later. Now area of triangle ABC, half into base into height. Base is T and height is B minus U, plus area of rectangle OACD is OA into OD, which is UT. Now from the expression V minus U by T is equal to A, we can also write V minus U as AT. So here S is equal to half T into AT plus UT. Now we can write it as UT plus half AT square. So this is the graphical method for S is equal to UT plus half AT square. The main points are from the graphs, ratio which gives a slope, we can determine one physical quantity. Product means the physical quantity will be obtained by the product of physical quantities where graph is taken. Thus the product will be obtained by area. So we have only two possibilities. So this is S is equal to UT plus half AT square. Well, now we will solve a problem. A car is traveling on a straight road at a speed of 22.5 meter per second. The driver applies brakes and causes a uniform retardation of 1.5 meter per second square. Find the stopping time of the car. So when car is in motion with a speed of 22.5 meter per second, so this is the initial speed which is moving, and uniform retardation is caused. What is meant by uniform retardation? Speed decreases uniformly. Means here retardation means speed decreases, negative acceleration. So here we take acceleration as minus 1.5 meter per second square. Since this is a retardation, so negative is applied. Why? Because acceleration means final velocity minus initial velocity by time. Retardation means final speed is decreasing. So when brakes are applied, the final speed will be, car comes to rest after applying brakes, so final speed will be zero.
you are asked to find after what time when brakes are applied car comes to rest. You are asked to find that time in which the car comes to rest. Here, looking into the data, what are the physical quantities we have? So, looking into the data, after taking the physical quantities, we can write equation of motion as V is equal to U plus AT, where V is 0, U is 22.5, this is negative acceleration minus 1.5 into T. So here T is 22.5 by 1.5. Now this is 1.5 15 since 15 15 is 225, 1.5 15 is 22.5. So this is 15 seconds. Means after brakes are applied, car comes to rest in 15 seconds. Okay. One more similar problem we will discuss. One more problem here. A car is traveling on a straight road at a speed of 72 km per hour. The driver suddenly sees the traffic light turn red and he applied the brakes and causes a uniform retardation 5 m/s². The car travels a distance of 45 m before coming to rest. After the driver sees this signal, find the reaction time of the driver. Here the question asked is, here driver at this point he sees the traffic signal turn right and he applied brakes so that it travels 45 m distance and comes to rest. When he is applying the brakes, the velocity he is having is 72 km/h. Finally, it comes to rest. But driver sees the traffic signal here. He may react after some seconds so that he may react here. Means he applied the brakes here, so it stops from B to C traveling. That means here some time is taken for the driver to apply the brakes. That time is called reaction time. When we see the traffic signal, immediately when we apply the brakes, but still it may take some seconds. So that reaction time is T. When he is applied brakes, before that it travels some distance. Here the brakes applied, so it stopped here. So now taking the data into consideration, now from the given data, retardation is minus 5 m/s². Initial velocity 72 km/h. Once I am telling you here kilometer per hour, how can we convert this kilometer per hour into meter per second? 1 km/h means kilo, 1000, 10 power 3 meter by hour. 1 hour is 60 minutes and again minute is 60 seconds. So this is 3600. So now 1000 by 3600 meter per second. Taking cancellations, so here this is 2 5s 2 18s, means 1 km/h is equal to 5 by 18 meter per second. So when the velocity will be given in terms of kilometer per hours, definitely we have to convert them into SI units, which are meter per second. So here u, initial velocity 72 kilometer per hour, where kilometer per hour is converted into meter per second by multiplying it with 5/18. It becomes 20 meter per second. So here u is 20, v 0, acceleration is retardation since brakes applied. So from this concept we can write v square minus u square is equal to 2as. So v square is 0 minus u square is 20 square, 2 into acceleration is minus 5 into s. So this is minus 400 is equal to minus 10 into s. So minus cancels, this is s is equal to 40 meters. After brakes applied, retardation causes the speed decreases and finally body comes to rest. So before coming to rest, after brakes applied, distance traveled is 40 meter. But when he see the signal at A, and before coming to rest, car traveled is 45 meter. That means there is a 5 meter distance traveled before he applied the brakes. Before he applied the brakes, he traveled 5 meter. Why? Because after he applied the brakes, then retardation causes the speed to decrease. So this is s is equal to 40 meters. But the total distance given is 45. That means what is the distance traveled before he comes to rest, before he applies the brakes? Before he applies the brakes, distance traveled, that is distance traveled is s1 is equal to total distance minus s, which is 45 minus 45 meter. Now here from A to B, brakes are not applied. That means there is no retardation, so that body travels with same velocity. So from A to B, body moves with uniform velocity. A to B, uniform velocity, since no retardation is there. So this is uniform velocity. Now here, for uniform velocity, constant velocity, acceleration 0 when there is no change in velocity from A to B, since brakes are applied at B only. So from A to B, brakes are not applied, so no acceleration, means there is no change in velocity. So here from the formula, S1 is equal to ut plus half at squared. Here this is 0 because from A to B it travels with uniform speed only. So this is ut S1. S1 is 40. Sorry, S1 is 5 and u is 20. This is t. This is 5/20. That means 1/4. So 0.25 seconds, or we can also say 1/4 second. That means when he sees the signal at A, when he sees the signal at A, he didn't apply the brakes here. Some time he taken to respond to the signal. So the reaction takes place at B. During this time, the car traveled through a distance s1. During that time, that reaction time, so the body traveled a distance s1. Here he applied brakes, means retardation acts from this point only. So from here the velocity gradually decreases and stops at C. From B to C the distance traveled is, after applying retardation, it is 40. But when he sees the signal from that point to where the car stopped, the distance is 45. Means he reacted after traveling a distance 5. Then how much time is taken for his reaction? It is 1/4 of a second. Okay, this is one model reaction time problem.